when the boys turned up missing last week, Morenci was thrust into the national spotlight in a way that very few cities of 2,000 people have ever experienced. And we certainly did not welcome the circumstances of the spotlight. I am very proud of the response that the community has given in this situation. We have seen our police and fire chiefs stand strongly under the extreme weight of the burden of the investigation and helping everyone to go through this. I can't say the totality of my appreciation. And that goes to the fire chief sister as well. These guys have done a tremendous job, along with their staff and the city hall staff. Everyone is exemplary. Thank you. We are not satisfied with the outcome. We will not be satisfied until the boys are home. But I do know our community wishes to say to all that have helped us in this time. We've been very humbled in this tragedy. We soon realized we are unable to handle this on our own. We are unable to fix it. And we reached out, and others have reached out to us. Early one night, I saw a list of over 20 organizations that had come forward already earlier in the investigation. 20 organizations and teams from outside of the community. Reading down that list, it brought tears to my eyes. I think that people cared about us that much. And as we move forward, That list is tripled now, right? We can't begin to name all the organizations, the teams, the agencies that have come to help. Though woefully inadequate, I say thanks. That's all we have to offer you, is to say thanks. Incredibly, the volunteers that have showed up each day have increased in this. I was quite sure that with the weariness of our workers, searchers, and the nasty weather that returned yesterday, that our numbers would be down. But yet, by my estimation, from what I've been able to gather, we might have had 400 searches yesterday. I think these volunteers do not all live in Morenci. Many of them come from our surrounding townships, surrounding communities. But what they have done, what they have shown us, whether they're tramping through the mud, serving sloppy joes, they are our neighbors in the truest sense of the word. Everything. Lastly, I know our community wants to reach out to the family. And fortunately, we really do not know what they're feeling, because not many of them say they've lost a kid. I'm glad that not very many of us can say that. But I do have a friend who lived with his son and lost him tragically. And lost our son on a cross. And that friend knows what you're going through. That friend can be a help where our words fall short. And I pray that you will allow him to give comfort or he cannot. We'll take a few questions today. And rather than all shouting out, I can't really hear. Let's just start over there and I'll try to come around.
Mr. Mayor, if you could say something to John Skelton, what would be?
John, if you know where they're at, please tell us. Anyone else?
No questions.
Yes, ma'am.
There have been talks that told the decorations away to the world's
champion. I've not heard those plans.
Mayor, you've had to suspend the services of recycling and closing City Hall because so many of your people are involved in the search. Is that correct?
Primarily, the closing of City Hall took place because of the need for the space for the command center and the dedication of City Hall staff to assisting in the investigation. The recycling center is located right outside this parking lot, and logistically, we worked out.
So, this is the first time then that in how many years since it's city's been established? I'll assume it's the first time this has ever happened. Maybe you can...
Closing the City Hall?
Yeah.
To my knowledge.
How many years has the city been established?
I can't tell you that either.
Thank you.
Decades.
Is the command post being relocated or is it being downsized?
The front offices, the public generally would frequent are being freed up. So they're down there. Something over here.
Do you think Skelton knows where they are?
I do not.
Do you think the kids are alive?
I certainly hope so. Until I see evidence to the contrary, we'll continue to look for that.
How is this impacting the kids?
Pardon me?
How is this, all this impacting the kids?
The police department have come in and worked so they cannot work anymore, both on the clock and off the clock. They are invested very deeply in this.
Do you have any idea what kind of cost this has to the city?
No, I do not. I think I'll take one more question.
How many full-timers on the police department?
We have 3 full-time law enforcement officers. That includes myself and 5 part-time employees.
Thank you very much.
Would one of you be able to tell?